looked like you had them on their heels for the first time all game?
We were just pressuring them, and I think they kind of panicked a little bit, and we got to going a little bit, but they responded with a couple big shots.
Yeah. You expect Donnie to spend more time, I guess, in film review more on the first half or the second half?
Man, I don't know. I just don't know.
Sorry you've been asked this, but obviously a loss like to this extent is always frustrating, but does it make it even more frustrating given the momentum that seemed to be generated from the way you guys pulled out that game on Wednesday?
It was kind of surprising seeing how he came out. But, in the second half, we kind of started bringing our own energy, but it wasn't enough. They did a good job of responding.
Josh, I'm sure you all have had some kind of eye-openers before, but with Kentucky coming in here in a couple days, a team with that kind of length, I mean, you know, Kentucky's got 5, 6, 7 guys with that kind of length. I mean, is that, if y'all haven't had an eye-opener yet, is that an eye-opener to what could happen when the effort and energy and sharpness isn't there?
Yeah, definitely. Especially in a league like the SEC with how it is this year. If you don't come out ready to play, that can happen against anybody. So you just got to bring it.
Is it surprising to you that LSU team did come in here 6-5? I mean, you've seen a lot of SEC teams. That one looks like it's maybe the second most talented team in the league.
Yeah, very talented. On a wing, guard spot, down low definitely. I think if they bring it every night, they could be a really good team.
Just how upset was Coach Tindall at the half? Can you kind of describe what that was like?
He was pissed. That's all I can say. I mean, he was just upset. But I think at the end of his speech, he was optimistic about the second half and told us that we had time to turn around.
Josh, when the coach is that mad and he's telling you guys, hey, that was the worst half I'd ever seen, do you guys kind of take that to heart a little bit?
I mean, yeah, if a coach being negative at all, you should take it to heart. So I don't think you should take all that to, you know, wake you up. But, yeah, it was pretty eye-opening at halftime.
Josh, with as much as y'all have to make it a team effort, you paint on defense, and you play that zone, I mean, how tough is it to do that and then cover up the perimeter? Because if they're kicking the ball around like that, I mean, someone's going to be open somewhere if you got a double or triple team.
We just got to contain guys off the dribble. I mean, I think they're getting too many straight line drives to kick out threes.
Getting what you did from Dietrich today. I mean, y'all have gone through stretches where it's hard to kind of put the ball in the bucket, and he's a kid who obviously can do that. Is it good to see him maybe starting to fight through whatever's been bothering him lately?
Yeah, definitely. I think he just went through a stretch. You know, pretty much every freshman goes through it. So I hope he's working his way out of it now.
He's a guy who can help y'all, right? I mean, with the way he can score the ball.
Definitely. He's a knockdown shooter. So I hope he can get a couple out of him.
Was it the toughest time you've had to try to penetrate into the lane this year? And maybe why do you think that was?
I think they did a good job of, you know, helping over, and I was finding my teammates.
Josh, Robert only scored 3 points tonight. Did he mention anything about his hand bothering him?
No. I mean, I don't know. He didn't say anything about it.
Josh, you're obviously a prideful guy. What's going through your mind personally at halftime? I know that you're probably listening to what Coach Tindall's saying, and he's in y'all's ear, but to a certain extent, I know you're a really prideful guy. There's got to be things you're thinking in your head at that point, right?
Yeah, I was just upset about how bad they was beating us, and then just how casual they started playing kind of bothered me. But I was told the guys we had 20 minutes to turn the game around, or at least try to, you know, make it a game.
I don't want to say satisfied because you wanted to win the game, but the way y'all came out in the second half, is that at least something?
I guess I'm just glad we didn't lay down and fold up like some teams could have. And we put together a pretty good run.
Josh,